Okay, welcome to the troubleshoot guide related to connecting and driver problems. We will first discuss the ANT connections. Let's go to the main screen. If we look to the right side, we can see that all the connections have a green tick. This is good. This means the connections are okay. When there's a problem, all the connections will have a red cross, as shown in here. It could also be that you will not see anything during the search option. Now close the software and go to Device Manager. In your Device Manager, the USB2 device is named under LibUSB32. Here you see the N+. If not, check the driver installation on the support site how to get this back. If you do see it, then something else is wrong. It could be that Garmin Express is installed on your PC. Check right bottom side if you see this logo. If so, close it. It means that the Garmin software is controlling the ANT antenna. If you start the Tacx Trainer software again, then you will see that all the green check marks are back again. When you have an iFlow or Fortius trainer, then a driver issue can be the problem. Then you also have the problem of the red crosses, or during a search in Device Manager, nothing can be found. This is how to solve it. Take out the USB cable. Check the link where to go to. This is your main installation folder for the Tacx Trainer Software 4. Now select Tacx drivers and right mouse click the Tacx driver setup and select Run as administrator. After the installation, you plug in a USB cable. You will see that the VR interface is being installed. To check if the drivers are correct installed, we need to go to our Windows Device Manager. Check under Yungo if you see the WinDriver 1200 and VR interface. When there are no yellow marks, it is good. Double check if the date of the VR interface is 2015. If this is 2010, then you need to remove the VR interface. Now start the Tacx Trainer software and you will see that all the connections are re-established.